You would agree that nature's beings are best loved from a safe distance. Nevertheless, some things are just beyond one's control. The chances of bumping into a gorilla in the wild are rather slim. Nevertheless, should you be out on a wasteland adventure and perhaps accidentally bump into one, the next action you take may just save you or launch you into a world of pain. Make yourself as tiny as possible by squatting very low, evading their gazes, and unhurriedly backing away from them. Gorillas are defensive, and when you raid their personal space, they tend to take it as a contest. They would likely launch into making noises, swaggering, and pounding their chest in annoyance. Let's get this point straight. You should do everything humanly possible to avoid getting up close and personal with a lion in the wild, except under the direction of an expert. In any case, should you find yourself under peril, make yourself appear as enormous and self-confident as possible by standing up tall and speaking at the top of your voice. This may sound really funny, but it is a known fact. If you ever appear weak around a lion, there is only one thing you should know. You have become possible prey. When you are in close contact with lions, climbing a tree would be the last thing you do. On the other hand, hippos won't even make attempts at climbing. No doubt, they may look cuddly, slow, cute, and docile, but in the real sense, a hippopotamus can be very brutal. If you find yourself in such a situation, climb on to the nearest tree and save your life. And just before we go on with this number, be careful not to apply this with the lions, given that they are definitely better at climbing than you can ever be. It is on the record that hippos claim about 500 lives every year. They are enormously territorial and overprotective of their young. Make no mistake about this. Right in the wild, an elephant is not as gentle as they appear while in captivity or in the movies. It will attack you instantly if it feels defenseless. And when they decide to do this, the best option would be to use their size against them. Get calmly behind something like a vehicle or a large rock where it will be tough for them to catch up and where you can also hide yourself entirely. These good-looking, distinctive creatures are often portrayed as gentle giants in widespread media, a repute only made worse by tourism that allows you to get up close and personal with them in captivity. This is one of the most long-term widespread folklore in all of the animal kingdom, but it is legend nonetheless. Urine makes worse the problem by encouraging the spikes to discharge additional venom. What you should do in this stead would be to rinse the affected area with the same fluid from which the jellyfish that ripped you probably came from, the ocean. Anyway, you have to know that not only does urine not offset the pain of a jellyfish bite, it makes the poison increase some more. Getting bitten by a snake can be undeniably horrifying. Although you may be feeling pretty anxious to get all the poison out, all those long-standing horse operas have led you astray. Sucking the venom will only offer little or no help at all. You are much better keeping your affected part below heart level to dawdle blood flow and then bandage the wound before getting medical attention as soon as possible. Not only is the snake attack itself terrifying and painful, but also because an ordinary person may not successfully identify a snake on sight, this simply means that the likelihood of venom often remains a forbidding question mark. This tip may sound really, really silly, but coughing can get you out of losing a bout with a kangaroo. A grunt-like sound or a low cough is a sign of compliance between kangaroos. If you want nothing of the fight a kangaroo is sure to offer, you would need only imitate this sound while backing away from a violent kangaroo. Just as it is with some other animals, running is expected to encourage a chase. If an alligator had already caught you unprepared, your chances are not that wonderful. The recommended thing to do at that moment would be to get away before they have the opportunity of clamping their powerful jaws down on you. Run as fast as your legs can and do that in a straight line. There is a little bit of bad news for you when it comes to an alligator attack. You know the myth about running in a zigzag formation while running from alligators? Forget that escape plan. Run as fast as your legs can and do it in a straight line. If sharks do confuse you for prey, nevertheless, you need to keep your faculties intact because freaking out and frantically swimming away will only make you look more like what they first suspected, prey. If you are in this situation, what you need to do is face the shark and gently swim backward and away from it. Despite what you may have heard, sharks are not known to attack humans nearly as often as the world has made it appear. Not even great whites. If a grizzly bear gets close enough to you, do not try to frighten it. Talk calmly while acting compliantly, then try to gradually back away. If the bear you encounter is a black bear, You should try to threaten them by standing up tall and making a thunderous noise while cautiously backing away.